Cheers! I'm Katrina, a singer-songwriter, and tonight I made a strawberry basil smash. Now don't go knocking my basil plant. You have to understand she lives in an urban garden, aka my third floor apartment windowsill. Basil has been doing the best she can with the resources she's been given. Aren't we all? Mmm, she smells so good. Okay, let's talk about some music. I love wearing makeup when I perform. I'm a sucker for a 1940s dress and a red lip. But due to some strange genetics, cultural influences, and a rebellious attitude towards capitalism, my makeup routine is quite limited and awkward. So hold on to your seats. You are about to watch the worst performance makeup tutorial ever. My view on face paint has been shaped by four different factors. Let's start with health. I am allergic to bubbles. Yes, that's a thing. I break out in hives whenever sodium lauryl sulfate hits my skin. When this compound gets mixed with water, it acts as a foaming agent. Just think of all the things you use every day that make bubbles. Soap, shampoo, conditioners, even toothpaste. No bubble baths for this girl. My sensitive skin also does not take well to a number of chemicals, leaving makeup options quite slim. I don't wear anything on my face. No foundations, no cover-up, no concealers. Just the occasional drop of coconut oil to moisturize. I also find it better for my mental health to focus more on enhancing things and less on covering things up. Although I appreciate lots of makeup styles, I selfishly prefer looking at people's faces when they have no cover-up on at all. I find different skin tones and freckles rather enjoyable. Let's move to culture. I'm an American girl raised by a French mother. Lots of super cool European influences sewed their way through my adolescence. One of them being the less is more outlook on beauty. A literal shake what your French mama gave you. And if you want to put makeup on, make it look as natural as possible. Essentially, don't be afraid to look like you, just with a little bit of added flair. That's what I try to look like when I'm on stage. Peut-être un jour, je peux faire une vidéo en français pour toi? Je dois étudier. The most important thing for me to add flair to is my eyes. I like to make sure that people in the audience can see my eyes so that they can feel connected to me and the music. I basically take a brown eyeliner pencil and outline my entire eye as far away from my eyeball as possible. Cause ew, eyeballs are gross. And then I layer my eyelid with a brownish purpley shadow that is probably nothing more than colored sand. It's rebellion time. You've seen the beauty commercials, right? They go a little something like this. Hey you, over there, with those short, thin, disgusting eyelashes. I bet that's the reason why no one's asked you on a date before. I bet it's also the reason why you get bad grades and have no friends. If you buy our luminous, voluminous lash wand, you'll finally be able to crawl out of the bridge that you've been living under. Sound familiar? It's called injecting you with poison and selling you the antidote. I may have been captured by the claws of capitalism when I was 14, but those claws will not get me today. Every once in a while, when I'm putting makeup on, I do a check-in with myself and say, "Self, are you putting this on because it's fun or because a commercial made you feel crappy about yourself?" I usually don't put anything on my eyelashes, but I curl them with this weird contraption. No one has been able to get me to put false eyelashes on yet. It's just the whole glue near your eyeball thing, you know? Last but not least, we have creativity. Much of my perspective on makeup comes from the excitement behind creating beautiful art. It's really no different than writing songs. One of my favorite things to have on stage is a pop of color, usually a pop of red. The color red is so strong and bold and beautiful. So I usually wear a red outfit or other red accessories and match it with a red lip. The only lip stain that doesn't hurt my lips happens to be called Naughty, which of course makes me feel naughtier than I actually am. I just kind of go for it and try to stay inside the lines. When it's showtime, in order to maintain my health, hold on to special cultures, and be creative while raging against the machine. This is usually what I come up with. Thank you for spending time with me tonight and entertaining my quite peculiar tutorial. Please tell me in the comments what your weird beauty habits are. Come join me next week to watch me make something out of the 2 bushels of apples I picked the other day. Who knew a bushel was really that big?